Hi guys, so everybody including myself tells you to make concise notes, but what are concise notes? How do we make them? Should we make them now or should we make them later? Don't worry, I'm going to show you exactly how I made my concise notes and I'm going to make sure that this query of yours is solved today in this video. Before I show you guys my concise notes and how I make them, let me first clarify what are concise notes. Concise notes are a short, crisp notes which contain all the important topics, by which I mean the previous year topics, in one place. But it does not mean that you have to make concise notes from the very, very starting of your first read. You know, your first read should be from, yes, a source which is not too vast, but you should read as much as you can within the allotted days for that subject. You know, you should try to read as many topics as you can. And then from there, you have to make your notes concise for your revisions. If you read from very, very concise notes from now itself, you are going to end up remembering not all of it. Obviously, if we read 100% today, we will be able to remember maybe 70 or 80% in the exam. But if you read 50% from today itself, you're going to end up remembering only 30 to 40%. And that is not going to get you that very, very good rank that you might want. So you have to concise your notes depending on what types of notes you have from the start. So if you have made notes from a source which is already concise in itself, for example, if you have done pharmacology from Dr. Gobind Rai Garg sir, I can vouch for that and tell you that they will not be more than 200 pages and sir's notes are already concise enough that you can revise them in the last 10 days. But you should revise them before the exam at least 2 to 3 times so that you have a visual memory and you can flip through the pages faster near the exam. For example, I show you my pharmac notes, approximately this much. And I have used that, you know, I did fold every page in half and I wrote on both halves, like I have told you in my previous videos, to save the space. In that way, my pharmac notes were only 150 pages and I was able to revise them before the exam without making them any more concise. So what you can do is make sure that you highlight and, you know, underline and star mark the important and previous year asked topics so that you can focus more on those points in your notes when you are flipping through the pages or if you run short of time. But you don't have to concise what does not need to be concised, if you know what I mean. The second type of source that you might have used are printed notes, and that's completely fine. I have also used printed notes of Marrow for physiology and biochemistry. I did watch the main videos and in my internship when I had time, but the notes of those videos are not at all revisable. They're very vast. So I'll show you exactly what I did to revise them. So these are my main notes for physiology from Marrow. I did get them printed out and you can see how vast they are. I did read it all. I watched the videos and simultaneously I underlined and highlighted whatever I felt was important. But obviously by the time it came to revise them, they were way too vast and not really, everything was not important as well. So what I decided to do was, I got the rapid revision notes printed out and I read these. I watched the rapid revision videos and I simultaneously read the notes. And in these rapid revision notes, I have added whatever extra points I felt was important. See, I added some extra blank pages at the end of the rapid revision and I wrote down all the previous year topics or the questions which were not already given in the rapid revision, as you can see. And there are many points which I have added between chapters as well within the given topic. And I have marked all the topics which have been asked in the previous year questions. For example, this indicator dilution principle is so important. And, you know, skeletal muscle contraction is so important. So I wrote a question mark with aims. And, you know, like that, I have really added post-its also to add some missing points. So this is how I made my revision notes wholesome. Was I added all the previous year topics and questions which are not in here already. And in this way, my main notes from physiology became concise. For biochemistry, I used Zainab ma'am's rapid revision to concise my notes. So this is my rapid revision of ma'am. As you can see here, I have added this slide extra of allosteric regulation because ma'am did not cover it, but I felt I wanted to revise it because I had read this concept before. And as you can see here also, I have written examples of competitive, uncompetitive and non-competitive inhibition because I felt they might ask that as well. And I also added this slide of transition states. And as you can see, you know, I wrote about anomers, enantiomers, epimers, and all the different glycosaminoglycans. And this is how I was able to concise my marrow of biochemistry into MAMS rapid revision. I made sure I read those main notes as well, and whatever I felt was extra or I felt I wanted to revise, I have added them into MAMS existing rapid revision. So you can follow any rapid revision you want, but you just have to make that source whole so that you feel confident that this is all you have to read at the end, but also it does not have many pages to revise. So a lot of you guys already use rapid revision to make concise notes, and I think that's a great idea, but please make sure to add all the missing topics and information to make those notes wholesome. And you can also refer to main videos to fill the concepts which you feel are not being covered in rapid revision. Just one last tip before I go, I wanted to tell you guys about concising your notes, is that concise your physiology, pathology, pharmacology all into the medicine system wise towards the end. Yes, I think you should read these subjects individually as subjects in the first read, but from your revision onwards, you should actually concise them all together. Like, you should add all the relevant physiology, pathology, pharmacology of any system, like for example CVS, into the CVS medicine notes, so that you don't read things twice or thrice for the same topic. And I feel it will help you integrate that entire system much better, and it will save so much time. So that is another trick you can try to concise your notes. I use Zena Ma'am's rapid revision of medicine, and because she has already taught the relevant physiology, pharmacology, and so I just tweaked it here and there, and as you can see, I just added a few points of whatever I felt needed to be revised from my side. And so that's all I needed to read for the systems of these four subjects, and that made my revision so much easier and faster. I want to conclude by saying that everybody has a different way of learning, and some things might suit you and some things might not. So you should really listen to your heart and whatever you feel is best for you, and that will sail you through. Even if you don't agree with what I have to say, that's completely fine. Have faith in what you are doing, and that will really yield you good results. Please like the video if you liked it and subscribe for more content, and please leave a comment if you have any other question about concising notes or about anything you might have in preparation. If you want to connect with me, please join my Telegram group, the link to which I'll leave in the description box below. Bye!